every Ramadan, shaitan is tied. So don't blame shaitan. We become little shayateen ourselves, right? It's you. It's not the devil. People say, but shaitan is tied. How come we're doing this? I say, because you, it's you. It's not the devil anymore. You've become a little devil. Astaghfirullah. Right? Every Ramadan, what happens? People are fighting in the masjid. About what? I promise you, it's about a fan. It's about a window. It's about the light. It's about the pace of the tarawih. It's about all those things every year. I promise you, it's happening. Right or wrong, guys? Did you hear them say right? No wonder they don't allow the women in. Astaghfirullah. May Allah forgive you. May Allah forgive you. The women would have sorted your matter out a long time ago. My brothers and sisters, it's absolutely important for us to note that to be considered a correct Muslim, you must be disciplined. You have to be disciplined. If you're not disciplined, you're going nowhere. And this type of advice, you know, when you hear someone across the globe sitting and telling you how you must calm down and so on, people say, oh, wow, lovely advice. But when we're listening to it from the Quran and the Sunnah, we don't take it seriously. It is golden advice. It is golden advice. We don't know how to differ. Let me give you another example. And I'm going to take the liberty of entering into this example because it's a reality. We're facing crises across the globe. You know what? We belong to different sects as Muslims. How do we treat each other? Again, abuse. We hurl dirtiest words. My brother, you have every right to believe what you're convinced by. It doesn't make the other person an evil person simply because he's convinced otherwise. You can discuss it. You should discuss it. You can raise it in a very respectful way, in a very, very polite way. It's probably going to be more effective and more convincing when you raise it with love, with compassion, with dignity, with goodness, rather than to start swearing, spewing. Don't look at them, don't greet them. I was saying moments ago, with us, our problem is in our own homes. We have a problem with our brothers. I'm sure it might be in this community. I don't know of any particular case, but I have five fingers. So if I were to tell you, you've got five fingers, it's not like I know the unseen. It's just something so normal and natural. It happens. Our own brother or sister, we will not talk to them for 20 years. And you're saying, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And you want to go into Jannah. وَالَّذِينَ يَقَطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَن يُوصَلَ وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ اللَّعْنَةِ. Allah says, those who break the ties that they are supposed to mend and those who cause chaos on earth, against them is the curse of Allah. I wonder why we're cursed. We can't even make peace. What's it over? I can tell you it's over a few things. Primarily, perhaps, it's over money. A few pounds. That's what it's over. Inheritance. Old man died and we've got a problem. That's why I say, the richer you are, trust me, the more concerned you must be about your children getting along with each other once you leave. You'd rather sort it out in your lifetime. I've known many wealthy families back from where I come from. Most of them totally broken after a generation or two. Totally. May Allah forgive us. We have a little issue. We cannot get along. We have small matters. I was saying someone from a different sect. We don't greet. We don't talk. We don't want. For what? My brother, if it was a business deal worth 10 million pounds, we would forget about all those differences. And we would say, hello, my brother. Salaam alaikum. How are you? Let me give you a big hug. Why? 10 million pounds, bro. I promise you, we'll invite each other to each other's homes. Totally different faith, totally different. Wallahi, we should be respecting each other prior to those 10 million. And even if they didn't ever come, we should be respecting each other in exactly the same way. What's wrong? Why? We cannot bring the baggage of far away to where we are. And we must learn to respect each other because the difficulties that we are facing are a direct result of our attitude at times. And the general norms need to become proper norms. It's not normal to start swearing a person you differ with. The Christians had their Christmas the other day. Was it yesterday? Let them have it, subhanAllah. Let them do whatever they have to. Why does someone need to spew hate? Why does someone need to say hurtful words? For what? The day you have your Eid, I'm sure you will be led to have that Eid in a beautiful way. They'll be happy for you. Subhanallah. We're living in a country where there's not just one religion. So many people from all over. You would never be able to know the exact number of religions in this country. You wouldn't know it. And we're a small, minute minority. Trust me. So small that you wouldn't even believe how small we are. Especially if you come from Bradford, you feel like you're living in a majority Muslim place, right? Trust me, it's not. Trust me, we're so little, but we get so excited about things. And then when we say something of this nature, people say, you know what? You're asking us to give up our faith? Not at all. Do you hear? Do you read? Do you understand? You remain with your faith. You remain. You believe. You can be a good Muslim. But you just have to understand, just like you have the right, they have the right. Just like you are convinced, they are convinced in another way. Just, and they will go back to Allah, and we will all answer to Allah. So if I'm wrong, I need to go back to the Quran, the Sunnah. I need to check with the scholars. I need to find out and keep asking, making sure that I'm doing the right thing. If I'm doing the wrong thing, I must change myself. It's not easy to say, I'm sorry. I was dealing with a divorce case, or not a divorce case, but actually a case of marital discord. And the woman says, if this guy comes and apologizes unconditionally, and I will take it. I will say, okay, give him another chance. Subhanallah. And this guy has never done that before. So I tell him, I said, brother, there's one way of sorting this matter. Simple. Your ego, throw it out. Come with your tail between your legs. And you know what? Just say, I'm very sorry. Whatever I did was unacceptable. I'll never do it again. I apologize. I cannot imagine the torment that I've put you through. I really feel that that was so unacceptable, and I'm not going to do it again. The woman immediately embraced the guy. It's okay. It's done. It's over. Because history in the making, someone who never apologizes suddenly says, I'm sorry. La ilaha illallah. Some of us here, we've never said I'm sorry in our lives. Never. Not once. Even when we know we're wrong, we still believe I'm right. It's me. How can I put my pride down? I'm older than these guys. I'm wealthier than these guys. I'm supposed to be the, you know, the higher of... How can I say I'm sorry? Come out and say I'm sorry. Because a day will come when the Almighty may not forgive you. Subhanallah.